More than 10,800 Lockheed P-38s were built during the Second World War. The P-38L model that we see here represents 3,810 aircraft. They were all powered by the Allison 1,475 horsepower inline engine. They had four 50 caliber machine guns and one 20 millimeter cannon. The max speed was 414 miles an hour up in the 20,000 foot range. They flew in every theater of operations during the Second World War, primarily as a fighter-bomber, but hundreds also served as photo recon ships. The P-38M night fighter appeared too late to see operational service. Many aces were made in the P-38, Richard Bong, Thomas McGuire, to mention just a few. The airplane was a classic, easy to identify by the public because of its twin boom, twin engine design. Sleek and fast, it was a hallmark fighter and reconnaissance aircraft of the Second World War. The crash site of the P-38L that we're visiting is located in a rugged and remote part of the Angeles National Forest. Here we see part of the nose landing gear leg assembly. The chaparral makes it difficult to see all the parts that are present at the crash site, and some of that chaparral includes poison oak. We see quite a bit of aluminum, fractured and shattered. Torn apart, we see fire damage. A lot of interesting material, to be sure. Some of the parts, including this armor plate, have a prefix number. And also the word face to tell the people putting the airplane together which way to face it in the aircraft to place it. Here we have part of the canopy frame assembly, and quite a bit of this was present. There was no glass or plexiglass, but the frame is in remarkable condition, all things considered, and we spent quite a bit of time looking at that, trying to figure out which piece goes where. Another piece of that frame assembly. And again, part of that canopy. Very interesting. This accident was especially tragic for Roy C. Carlson. He had departed Lockheed Air Terminal, and he went on a factory test flight to give the P-38 its first high-altitude test, running up into the high 20,000-foot range. On completing that, he was headed back to Burbank Field, but clouds enshrouded the L.A. basin, and they covered right up to the mountain slopes to an elevation of over 4,000 feet. Witnesses on a nearby mountain saw the P-38 under the overcast as it zoomed across a canyon and pulled up, striking a ridgeline, killing the pilot instantly. More of that wreckage. More aluminum. Some of this shows the evidence of fire damage. Here we see a gear associated with the Allison power plant, a gear assembly. Under the chaparral and in the growth, more aluminum. Some of this material was damaged during brush fires that have swept through the area over the years. And then the chaparral grows back and the fires come again. Each time they do a little more damage to the wreck site. More material. Now this is very interesting, the Allison engine. So you see the crankshaft assembly here. Although it's busted up, you know it's that power plant. These numbers here are not associated with Lockheed, but a subassembly manufacturer. So here you see a piston head and the sleeves, cylinder head. Very interesting. More of that power plant, long silent since 1944. another view. And more of the wreckage. Looking always for interesting prefix numbers and assemblies that could be identified. And this piece, cast assembly attached to frame. And this piece here we think is associated for sure with the landing gear, probably the nose gear on the aircraft. Here we get another view of that assembly. More wreckage down by the rock in the chaparral. Much to see, a heavy piece there. Quite a bit of material. You never know what you're going to find. You work through it as best you can. The yellow paint on the wreckage was placed there by the Civil Air Patrol years ago. Normally they painted an X on the wing, and other yellow paint was just slopped on the wreckage. And that told people hiking by or flying by it was a known wreck and they didn't need to report it. So here we see more structure, more aluminum. In amazing condition, considering everything it's been through. And here's a rocker arm assembly. That's a rare find. Landing gear, main landing gear, very heavy. More of the aluminum scattered everywhere at this impact site. Additional material, shredded, compressed aluminum. This is a great piece because it has the prefix series. And of course, Lockheed ran a continuum. It wasn't a prefix with a dash. 22, 23, 24. Another good view of material here. Lightning holes from a Lockheed Lightning. And more wreckage in that dense undergrowth and chaparral. Several pieces associated with the fuel tank were found, the fittings that go on those self-sealing tanks. Lockheed Corporation factory test pilot Roy C. Cameron was only 29 years of age at the time of his death. Here we see him with a B-17. Lockheed built the B-17 under license.